in your house, and this is In Your House 9, or 1996. The winner is Jake Roberts in the pre-show battle royal. And Mark Maron's final elimination, Yokozuna got most eliminations out of the match. The Body Diamonds here beat Savio Vega and Ahmed Johnson 1-2-3 clean in the middle of the ring. Afterwards, the Body Diamonds shake hands of Ahmed Johnson and Savio Vega to turn and face. I have a reason for this. You'll see play out. Triple H here is opening has an open challenge, and none other than Bret the Hitman Hart accepts it. They have a great chemistry. I did not know that. I didn't expect that. I really don't recall any matches between these two, but I think Bret Hart, he returned from medical leave, and I figured have him show up on a pay-per-view surprise would be cool. But realistically, WWE would have advertised it as it would result in more pay-per-view buys. No matter how big Shawn was at the time, Bret Hart still had a following that wasn't Shawn's fans, maybe. And I figured this would be a prime way to introduce him, with him getting a submission victory with the sharpshooter over Triple H. Right here, Stone Cold attacks Vince McMahon. They're in a storyline. This is like Stone Cold just being on card, and like him just showing up and like hitting someone with a stunner. Not only it's him doing that, and it's foreshadowing the storyline down the future, like way down the future. Right here we get Mankind having a promo on Psycho Sid. Mankind beats Psycho Sid with double arm DDT. Then here Owen says he has Brush's Bulldogs back later in the night. Then Goldust cuts a promo on Ken Shamrock saying he wants his title back. Ken Shamrock beats Goldust with the ankle lock, making the second event for his Intercontinental title. That feud is over with. I don't know who I'm going to have Ken Shamrock feud with next, as I've been having a lot of guys like new and stuff, but most of them have been faces, and I turned some guys face that could men. So I don't know where I'm going to go with the Intercontinental title, but I expect something fun. British Bulldog here cuts a promo on Undertaker. The Undertaker defeats British Bulldog with the tombstone, and during the match, we had Owen Hart run in and attack the Undertaker. Now, I had Owen Hart interfere and save British Bulldog back as a way to keep him on the show and keep him relevant, and to show that him and British Bulldog are friendly and they're teammates and they're tag partners. Then Jim Cornette cuts a promo on Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels cuts a promo on Vader. And Vader retains Shawn Michaels by pinfall. Excellent in-ring action and great heat from the audience. That's what you want. Now, I had Vader won here cleanly. No cheating. It's twice in a row. I protected Shawn Michaels. His popularity doesn't drop a lot. And I started the match slow and have a big finish. And I think that's a good way to go with like a bigger guy match, and that's all this match would want in real life. That ends the show. We end up having an 83-8. So what did you tell me? What did you think of the Bret the Hitman Hart return? Did I handle it correctly? Should I have hyped it? Who should Vader face next for the title? Who should I bring in? What feuds? Who's Ken Shamrock going to feud with next? Let me know. Love to hear any thoughts and comments on the show. Look, any feedback's great feedback in my opinion, even if you tell me I'm shit, which would be funny to me. Thank you for watching. Have a